Hey kids, today we're making crackle cookies with Bain and Scott.
It's YouTube, best for creative thing, cooking and crafting.
Here we are today with Uncle Scott and Bain. They are going to be the two that are going to put together this lovely recipe. And let's begin.
I'm gonna do this one. Uncle does the blue one.
He'll do the blue one. Okay. So then in this mixing bowl, you want to put the sugar. That's a half of a cup of sugar.
What's for this
mixing bowl? We'll worry about that later. So in this one, we're going to put half of a cup of sugar.
What does Uncle get
to? He'll get to do the flour and all that fun stuff. Okay, no, put it all in there. Can you put it all in there?
Sure.
All of it. Okay, now put that on the side and add your egg. One egg.
Oh, I wanted to do that.
One egg. Put it in. Ooh, glibbly, 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 glue. And then you want to do 2 tablespoons of oil. Uncle can help you with this. He'll put in this, which is one of these squares of Baker's unsweetened chocolate, and I have melted it and allowed it to sit to start to get a little cool. And then we're also going to have Uncle help you with this, which is, or maybe I'll do that. You hold it real still over the bowl. Hold it over the bowl. There you go. And we're going to put in a half of a teaspoon of vanilla. Oops. Auntie likes to oops a lot on the vanilla. Now you go ahead and mix that all up. Combine it all up in there with that whisk. All right, Bain, you can put that on the side. You did an excellent job. Okay, so now in that bowl right there, Uncle Scott is going to be adding 1/2 cup of all-purpose flour.
Oh, I knew it.
As well as in that little bowl, I have combined 3/4 teaspoon of baking powder and 1/8 teaspoon of salt. And maybe Bain can go ahead and mix it up with that whisk. So go ahead and mix that up. Bring your other bag, your other bowl back. Bring it closer to you. And Uncle is going to gradually add in, while you're stirring, he's going to add in the flour to that, okay? And we're going to continue to mix until combined.
Cool.
We are then going to put that into the refrigerator for at least 2 hours. And we're going to let that chill in the refrigerator. So after 2 hours, we'll be back. Say, we'll be back.
We'll be back, Auntie.
Well, maybe you won't be because your mom's going to come and pick you up, unfortunately. We're standing here trying to debate how such a little recipe is supposed to make 1.5 dozen. I mean, there's hardly anything in there. It has been more than 2 hours since this has been in the refrigerator. And this all broke down to like this tiny little bowl here. And it says here to flour your hands, but you know that I like to use my, sugar your hands. You know I like to use my cookie scoop because I really do want to try to keep them as uniform in size as possible. So I'm just going to scoop them up with my scooper, and if I start getting a little bit of a hard time doing that, then I'll go ahead and, you know, add in a little bit of sugar action up in there. And we're going to put them on our baking sheet for about 2 inches apart from one another. So they're supposed to be shaped into like a one inch ball. So this is about what it should be. So I'm not too worried that it's being, you know, made too big. So I'm going to go ahead and continue to roll these little guys and place them 2 inches apart from one another. I made 10 of them. So in our preheated 350 degree oven, I'm going to bake these for about 10 to 12 minutes. We'll be back. They didn't spread out very much, but they did sure poof up. They look so pretty. I'm gonna guess they're gonna poof down. Crackle Cookies, enjoy. They have a great chocolatey flavor. I found them, unfortunately, a little dry. They're not really super hard. Not sure how to explain it, but I think if I made these again, I would press them down and maybe get them a little bit more crunchy. Not sure what to do about it being dry. Maybe it's just, you know, that it needs to cook just a little less. Either way, they taste pretty good. Enjoy. Do you need a scraper for that,
Scott?
Oh, well, because I really enjoy the flavor of a vanilla. So, up here. No, just move. Just put it right. Put it. No, put it. Move. You can lick that. No, just your finger. All right, so move that bowl up over here just a little bit. Yeah, because it's unsweetened chocolate. Look at the face. Do the face again. Ooh. So, okay, let me. You can go ahead and dip your finger in there. It's only going to be for us. So you can go ahead and try it. But it's still going to, after it gets cooked, it's supposed to be rolled in powdered sugar, so the powdered sugar adds another level of sweetness to the cookie. But it shouldn't be too incredibly sweet, right?
Yummy.
You like that? Okay.
Too sweet.
Here, no more in the box. Ah, that's like double dipping, bro. All right, so here, you take that
and pick it up.
Yeah. Alrighty. Say bye to the people.
Bye.